seized. What is good, everybody? Welcome back to another My Damn Toys video. Today, I'm going to be taking you through my brand new WWE action figure backstage arena. It's been a long time since we've updated it, like a really, really long time, since I moved into this new house at the beginning of the summer. So it's been about 6 months or so since I've updated it, and it is finally time. I just know freaking Randy Orton took a nosedive. But anyways, guys, I did fix it up. I still have the sold out arena set up. If you guys have not seen sold out, definitely go click it right now. You can go check out MDT Sold Out 2018. And I appreciate all the positive feedback so far. But I wanted to go ahead and update the arena. I also hung some new championships on the wall. Got the Universal Championship and the Big Eagle Attitude Era WWF Championship. So very happy to update the room here, guys. But let's go ahead and get into this WWE action figure backstage tour. So I guess we can start off on the left side of the arena, guys. There is a hallway right here. You know, the GM's office used to be right here, and then behind that was the locker room, but I could never get to the locker room with this available. I can now remove the GM's office and get all this space right here, so I'm very excited for that. We do have some chairs and stuff stacked up. We got Bobby Lashley and some medical equipment over here in the corner. He's got a headache because of No Way Jose from MDT Live, episode number 9. Over here, we have a ladder set up on the ground. You know, it really gives it that realistic feel. You got a chair. Over here, you have me interviewing the MDT champion, John Cena. And so that's just a nice area right there. I've never had an interview area before, but I really like the way this came out. I used the Extreme Sets backgrounds for all of this stuff. We got the interview area back there. I thought the cage really brought it together. It makes it, you know, gives it sort of Attitude Era slash Ruthless Aggression Era style feel. So I like the way that looks. You got a ladder set up over there. You have the TV screen behind there. You know, you can show logos or MDT Live or whatever I want to show on there, I can do that. He's got his MDT Championship as well on his suitcase. So John Cena traveling with the championship. We go over here to the right a little bit, and you will see we got Seth freaking Rollins chilling on this little storage unit. We have Randy Orton, the Viper, the Legend Killer, walking in the door with his big old bag. And you can see that's sort of like the exit doors. We have the MDT United States Champion, Shelton Benjamin, down here. And if you guys can see right here, if we go over the GM's office wall, you'll see the Usos talking it up. And over here, we have the curtain. And the curtain leads down the hallway. And then you will go out the front entrance of Sold Out. So again, go check out that pay-per-view so you guys will know what's up with the pick fed. But anyways, that is where the superstars head off to the ring. To the right there, you got some cameras set up on a little storage unit. You know, you got lots of equipment back here that you got to pack up and go each city to city. You got No Way Jose. We'll get a little lower shot right here. You can see No Way Jose dancing away to his music over here. You got a big old storage unit again for all that equipment. Another storage unit over here on this side. I think it really gives it that backstage WWE feel. You know, just looking down the hallway, I really like the depth effect that it creates. We got a chair set up over here. Some drinks and a cooler, a table set up, little garage door and everything. So this is just a sort of boring little hallway here, but plenty of space to maneuver. Over on this side, you do have the door to the MDT General Manager's office. So I did take some foam board, created this wall, painted it up nice, and then added the WWE figure backstage playset door, and then I put my own logo over it to, you know, give it a realistic feel. And then if you go through the door, guys, you have the MDT General Manager's office, you know, where the interim General Manager of Vindication, Kenny Omega, and then the MDT Live GM, Eric Bischoff, can chill and do all the work they need to do. It's a bit boring in here. I need to put some stuff over here on the walls. I need to add some stuff to the shelves. But you can see right here, you got MDT Live, Vindication, and then the official draft poster up on the wall. And that pretty much does it for the General Manager's office. But I'm really enjoying the way this looks. I like it a lot better than the other way. You know, we used to just have like this little space here. When you come through the curtain, we'd have like a little space here and then a little bit of space in front of the GM's office. So now we have like this entire little area to work with. And if I want to, you know, get back there, I can just remove the GM's office. It's literally, I can pick this up all at once and move it out of the way to get back in the backstage and, you know, film segments for MDT Live, Vindication, you know, backstage segments, street fights, whatever the case may be. So I'm very excited to see what we do with it from now on. But that pretty much does it for the brand new WWE figure MDT Backstage Arena Tour, guys. Thank you so very much for watching. I'd love to know your thoughts on what you think of the new setup. Do you guys like it this way? You like it the old way? Or do you prefer it the way it was at the old house? Let me know down in the comment section below. Follow me on Instagram and Twitter at MyDamnToys, and I will see you guys in the next video. Thank you.